What is going on, guys? Today we are doing a commented video idea. This is a video that someone left in my comments as an idea, and I will absolutely do these. BlakeyBoy1716 says, bro, you should do ranking NFL wide receiver and QB duos in a tier list if you have not done it already. Well, I have not done it already, and yes, sir, BlakeyBoy1716, I will absolutely do that. So, why don't we go ahead and get right into this video? But before we do, actually, I do want to say, I'm going to create a Discord for my channel, just in general, so somebody can, you know, reach out to me, give me video ideas, kind of make a community off of this. So I'll be putting that down in the comments below, in the bio of this video, or whatever it's called. And yeah, let's get right into this video. So here we are with this tier list, and you know, this is quarterback wide receiver duo. So let's go ahead and jump right into this. First off, we have, you know, I'm not going to go in any order here really, but I'm going to throw probably one of the best duos in the league up easily. But actually, we'll throw the best two up pretty much. Kansas City is the best. They just are. Buffalo is number two in my opinion. You might argue Cincinnati. I'm going to go and put them in gray. I'll just kind of do those three right now. You might argue Cincinnati's better than Buffalo. Some might. To me, Josh Allen is just a hair better than Joe Burrow, just a little bit, and so he wins that. And also, Stephon Diggs is a hair better than Jamar Chase. And so, you know, really, you kind of just win that one out. And even if you want to say Burrow is better than Allen, I still would take Diggs over Chase. So that gives me the Buffalo Bills are ahead of them, just in my opinion. Moving on, let's find something a little special here. Let's go Baltimore. It's hard because he's a tight end. I'm gonna go. So let me go back a little bit. Actually, Kansas City is Travis Kelce and Patrick Mahomes. And then you know I'm gonna include tight ends because some tight ends are just the best receiving threat on a given team, like the Ravens with Mark Andrews and Lamar Jackson. I have to put them in great as well. They're just it's a dynamic duo, man. Mark Andrews has been so dang good, and it's just hard to do anything else. I'll also jump to San Francisco, kind of the best teams in the NFL at this point. Other than Baltimore, I guess. They're kind of in the middle. But San Francisco, I'm going to put them at... This is tough. I'm going to put them in meh tier, and I'm going to explain this. So, it's... Brock Purdy is the quarterback. George Kittle is the receiver here. Because I think Kittle is a better receiving threat than Debo. Yes, they use Debo for more. Yes, they use Kittle to block a lot. But Kittle in the outright position is just better. That also is kind of goes into this as to why I don't put them there. You might be like, well, that should make them all better because they have so many options. But at the same time, it's just there's too much. I mean, Christian McCaffrey's borderline a better receiving threat sometimes. That seems hard to pick. Brock Purdy had a great season, had a great 8 wins. He threw 170 yards per game. He's not amazing. He's fine. But that's it. So, you know what? I'll bump them to good, but they're going to be the back end of good for sure. Next, let's go to, let's get a rookie in here. Yeah, Texans, bad. Stroud, and I put Dalton Schultz. I don't think Robert Woods, Nico Collins, or John Mechie are really anything better than Schultz at this point. And that says more about the rest of the receivers than it does Schultz. That's a bad group of receivers, I'm going to be honest with you. So, Stroud could be good, could be bad. We don't know yet, but right now with that group as we're looking at it, it's just, it's not great. Moving on from there. Let's do another tight end combo, Ridder and Pitts. I'll put them in the meh tier. That one's just tough because Pitts has shown flashes, but also had a lot of inconsistencies in his game. Ridder has not shown much. Granted, he started like 4 games. I can't really hate him for that. It's not his fault, but I can't give him a full load of credit for that, putting him in the meh tier. Let's try to find a bad tier here, the Giants. I believe I have Daniel Jones and Darren Waller for this one. Another tight end, just happenstance. Darren Waller can't stay healthy. Darius Slayton could be an option, but Waller at his peak is probably the best player on that team outside of Saquon Barkley. It's just he's got to stay healthy, so there's a huge question mark there. That one was really tough to pick, honestly, so it is what it is. Next, we'll move on to Dak and CeeDee. This is tough. I'm putting them in good, which makes me want to bounce 49ers down. Dak is better than Purdy. It says more about Purdy than Dak. Dak's not that great. CeeDee is worse than Kittle by a good margin, and that says more about Kittle because he's just so great. It's just there's kind of a middle ground there, and there's no way to make that up. So I'll give him that. Jordan Love and Christian Watson, I'm going to put them in bad as well. That could jump up to lower than average pretty quickly. Christian Watson He has some flashes last year. I like Christian Watson. I think he will be a good receiver in the NFL. But as it sits right now, I can't give him more than that. Same with Jordan Love. He started one game, and that was a terrible game for him. Moving on from there, we'll go to Stafford and Kupp. Put them in the great tier when healthy, I guess. But it is what it is. Then the Dolphins. I'm going to put them in good tier, but they're going to stay at the very top of good tier. That's just because of Tua being a little bit on the lower end of quarterback size. You know, it's just, it is what it is there. Moving on from there, this one's tough. I kind of want to put the Raiders out here, but where do I put them? Jimmy G and Devontae Adams, that's the duo. Tua and Tyreek, obviously. I'm just making sure I didn't miss anything. Yeah, Jimmy G and Devontae Adams. Adams is, to me, he might be the best receiver in all of football, so you've got to give him that. But Jimmy G is just not that great. I'm going to put them in good. Yeah, I'll put them in good. That's fine. Sorry. I brain farted there a little bit. But yeah, there you go. Eagles. Jalen Hurts and A.J. Brown. That's a great duo. It is. It just is. Get over it. Let's go with... I thought of somebody a minute ago. Ah, yeah. Okay. Justin Jefferson and Kirk Cousins. Kirk Cousins is good enough to push them into the great tier. Justin Jefferson, obviously one of the best receivers in football, if not the best. So, Kirk Cousins... You compare him to Dak, and people say that Dak's just more athletic Kirk Cousins. Well, Kirk Cousins doesn't throw the ball into the other team 15 times in 13 games. Just doesn't happen. So, you know, I'm giving Kirk Cousins a bit of a nod up over Dak, for sure. Next, we'll move on to the Chargers. That's another... that's tough. I'm going to put them at the back of great. Herbert is really good. Keenan Allen, when healthy, is really good. I've got to put them in great. Cardinals. Kyler and Marquise Brown. I know Kyler's going to be hurt for most of, not all of this season, but yeah, that's just Marquise Brown. I mean, Kyler is probably a top 12-ish quarterback. I'm just kind of going off the brain here, but he's a really good quarterback, extremely underrated, extremely hated at this point for no reason, really. But Kyler is a good player. Marquise Brown is not a number one. He might not even be a number two in all things considered, so can't put them there. We'll go to Justin Fields and DJ Moore, lower than average, and that's because of Justin Fields. DJ Moore is also, he's been heralded as this great receiver. He's very good. He's not great. This, getting DJ Moore to the Bears does not equate to Josh Allen and the Bills getting Stephon Diggs or Jalen Hurts and the Eagles getting AJ Brown. It just doesn't. That's not the same thing. So let's hamper our expectations there to save Justin Fields a little bit. But yeah, that is a lower than average duo for sure. Bryce Young and Adam Thielen, also a lower than average duo. Just going to be tough. Michael Pittman and Anthony Richardson. This one's tough. In terms of a quarterback wide receiver duo, I really want to put them in meh just because I think Michael Pittman is pretty dang good, but I'm going to stick them in the very top of lower than average. These tiers aren't necessarily sorted into, like, the Bengals aren't necessarily better than the Ravens, or the Ravens aren't necessarily better than the Rams, etc., etc. It's just, you know, there's sometimes I'll mention, you know, whatever. You get the point. The Steelers. I'm going to put that in meh tier. And this is another one. This is my team, for sure. You see the Le'Veon Bell thing right back there. But my point to this is Kenny Pickett didn't do a whole lot last year. Steelers fans don't act like he did. I could easily put this in lower than average. Excuse me. But Deontay Johnson is who I'm going with the receiver here. And yes, Pickett to Pickens. Pickett, whatever. That, yeah, sounds great in terms of, like, I don't know, marketing or something, but here I'm talking about the receiver one. And yes, a lot of Steelers fans want to say Pickens is the number one receiver. Since when? He has had an okay rookie year. I expect him to have a really good second year, but let's not act like he's just been this dominant force. Deontay Johnson has been a number one wide receiver for 3 or 4 years now for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Yes, he didn't score a touchdown. That's not necessarily his fault. You got to put players in the spot to score touchdowns for, first off, as an offensive coordinator. Then the quarterback has to throw you catchable balls in the end zone where you're not trying to toe tap with just your big toes on the far corner of the end zone. It just, bad situation. Either way, Deontay Johnson is that guy, and he's a very good receiver. Not great, but very good. Moving on from there, the Detroit Lions, Jared Goff and Amon-Ra St. Brown. That's a good duo. I'll give them that. Derek Carr and Chris Olave, a good duo. Trevor Lawrence and Christian Kirk. I'm going to give him Kirk because Ridley hasn't played. That's a good duo. Geno and Lockett, that's a good duo. But that's tough a little bit because that's mainly just Lockett carrying him there. I think Lockett's better than DK just a little bit. They're very close. Like, in terms of Madden ratings, you look at their Madden ratings, it's like an 89 and 88, like, whatever, it doesn't matter. But yeah, moving on, Sam Howell and Terry McLaurin, I'm putting them in meh, the very top of meh, just because of Sam Howell. We don't know what to expect. I wish the best for Sam Howell. I really liked him coming out of last year's draft, but McLaurin's great. McLaurin is very underrated, don't get me wrong. So don't think he's not better than Lockett or Kirk or whatever. He is. Howell is just a complete question mark. You think that Desmond Ridder is a question mark? This guy played one game. Like, we don't know nothing about him. So he could be awful. So that's why I'm putting them in meh. Don't hate on me for that one. That one, just trust the process on that a little bit. The New York Jets, Aaron Rodgers and Garrett Wilson. That's a good duo. Not quite great. Could be great this season, though, pretty quick, I will say. Baker Mayfield and Mike Evans. I'm going to put that in the top of meh tier. Mike Evans is so dang good, and not to mention Chris Godwin, but we're just doing a duo, so like one receiver, best receiver, Mike Evans. And I like Baker. I could put him in good, but I'm going to put him in meh. Amari Cooper and Deshaun Watson, that's a good duo. Russell Wilson and Jerry Jeudy, I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt for now and give them the meh tier, or the good tier. I think Russ will probably play better than he did last year. I think that was just a downward year thing. I don't know, but I have trust in Russ a little bit. Mac Jones, and I think Juju would be that. That's a meh duo. Juju's a fine receiver. He's probably a second wide receiver, but Mac's just not a great quarterback. And then the Tennessee Titans. Ryan Tannehill for now, and DeAndre Hopkins. That's a tough one. I'm going to put them in the good tier, just because I can't necessarily... I mean, it's D-Hop. You know, you can't really hate on him too hard. So, let me go ahead and fix this for y'all a little bit so y'all can see this a little better. There we go. All right, so here is our tier list. We have Kansas City and Buffalo as the best duos, easily, not even close. Great duos, the Bengals, the Ravens, and that's Mark Andrews there. So there's some tight ends in here, remember. The Rams with Cooper and Stafford when they're healthy. Cooper Kupp, excuse me. A.J. Brown and Jalen Hurts. Kirk Cousins and Justin Jefferson. Justin Jefferson carries. Justin Herbert and Keenan Allen. The good tier, I'm just going to let y'all see those. The man tier, you got to remember Baker, you got to remember Sam Howell, you got to remember Desmond Ridder, Kenny Pickett, Mac Jones. Kind of the quarterbacks in that tier, it seems like, that really bogged that down. And then lower than average, you know, Anthony Richardson hasn't done anything yet. Neither is Bryce Young. Justin Fields is a terrible passer at this point, even though he's been really good at a lot of other things. And then Kyler is, he's very good. He's probably a top 12-ish quarterback. I don't hate on him, but Marquise Brown's not a number one, hardly a number two receiver. The Giants, Darren Waller, if he's healthy. Daniel Jones, kind of meh. And then bad. No hate to you guys. It's just there's not a really good situation there in the receiver room right now. So either way, that is going to be all for this tier list. All right, guys. I hope y'all enjoyed that video. Thank y'all for watching very much. Remember, the Discord link, if you want to join, is down in the comments whenever I post this. And I will see you soon. Peace.